So what we want to do today is we want to talk about future affiliate marketing. Before that, I just want to talk about the hashtag. So a lot of people think that hashtags are limited only and only to Twitter. Right? That's not the case. Go ahead, post on Facebook, post on LinkedIn, post anywhere, right? And you can tag all of us all. So what we want to do today is we want to talk about affiliate marketing, right? We want to talk about future of affiliate marketing. We want to talk about a few points of where affiliate marketing is going and so on and so forth. I have a very distinguished panel with me. All of them are experts. They have spent years, their lives in affiliate marketing and much more in digital advertising. Right, so the first, I think one of the main questions that all of us want to understand, and I want to start with the hottest topic over here right now, is, you know, what's happening in affiliate marketing when it comes to, say, for example, machine learning, right? I mean, is affiliate marketing part of machine learning? Is it advanced in technology? Or is it still that, you know, there are a lot of mutual connections, it's more up depending on your network and so on and so forth? That is something that I want to understand. I represent a brand over here, and as a brand, it's very important for me to understand that how affiliate marketing is progressing in terms of technology. So would any of you want to pick that up?
Maybe I can start. I'll dare to take the word, as I'm not Indian, so I'm a little bit, you know, nervous about talking to an Indian, you know, big room. But I think it's my second home. I come here every year at least twice for 10 years now. Awesome. When it comes to machine learning, it's a very sensitive topic for me. As main ad, as in partnership with Google, developed his own machine learning, and it's important for us because now we have a product called Logico to use that in detecting the quality of the traffic. So through the our DSP and the bidder, we are able to connect with the SSP to detect the traffic, and so in 100 milliseconds we can detect if the traffic is good or not. So the future will be to let this machine learning to be at the use of the advertisers, so the brands, in having a better clarity and visibility.
So yeah, I mean, that's very interesting and important from a brand's perspective also, because today I, as a brand, don't want any traffic which is substandard, right? And if machine learning is serving that, that is great. Right? Another question that I have as a brand is that, you know, I am always very, very curious. I mean, it's very transactional. I see that, you know, there's a cost per sale model, cost per lead model, but where is the creativity? Where is the, how do you project my brand as a creative brand, right? Is it just about a banner ad, or is it much more than that? I just want to understand.
On? Yeah. Yeah. Don't act like Arnav, okay?
But the nation wants to know.
Ian wants to know. Great. See, it's very important. What is happening, affiliate industry is not, is people are seeing as a data industry. That is the biggest problem. But in last couple of years, has moved from data industry to more of creative and content industry. So there is a, affiliate industry deal with technology a lot. Because brand gives a subject line, or brand gives a tagline, this is what you want to use. Baba, mera technology accept nahi kar raha. Can you rework on it? So this is what affiliate industry is trying to help brands, how to read, how to give a new content, which helps this part of the technology. Because email, you give a subject line of more than 20 words, it doesn't work. You can finish it in 2 words also. That is what the affiliate industry which is doing today. And the creative, they will give it 3 down. You need to do the email creatives, what we do. But no need to do that. You can finish in 2 texts or 2 lines also. End of the day, you need a response from it. I think brands are accepting the kind of new creativity for this part of the side of the technology, and which is working very well. And affiliate industry is moving not just from a technology or pushing or banner ads, but they're getting into a lot of creativity. They're developing the teams of creativity because they're failing otherwise. They're doing a lot of new creativity on content, which ValueLeaf adds every day in, day out. We are, our team is much more in creative than the campaign managers.
Awesome, awesome. So I look forward to some of those campaigns, right? I mean, yes. Because creativity is what makes a brand different in today's world when there are thousands and thousands of ads that all of us see every day, right? So, interesting, right? So when I talked about machine learning, he talked something very interesting, right? That, you know, they can detect fraud in 100 milliseconds. Is there something similar happening in AI? I have no idea, but I would like to know from you guys. Right? Is AI and affiliate marketing being integrated? Is there some advancement happening in that field? And if yes, I'm sure all of us would like to understand, learn a little bit about that.
Yeah. There are a lot of media buyers and affiliate managers. Whenever you have a lot of networks with different campaigns, different payouts, different conditions. But now AI isn't coming into picture whereby they're deciding, not the affiliate manager who's deciding which campaign to pick up, but the machine learning is deciding which campaign to pick up, at what payout, and everything. A lot of media buyers, especially in West Side and now in India also, use that kind of technology to decide on the kind of campaign.
I think just to add to it, I think AI is something which is widely talked about. I think when we go into AI and want to use it for affiliate, I think we have to first understand what is AI. I mean, in a way, I'm not saying you don't understand. We all have to understand. When we talk about AI and we look at a bot or a technology which is going to help solve an issue, we have to understand that AI is going to be in two sections, right? One is just going to be a rule-based AI, right? Where I train a bot, say, if this gentleman is going to ask you a question, A, the answer should be B, right? If the gentleman is going to ask you a question, C, the answer should be X, right? That's very, you know, A is equal to B sort of a scenario. I think when you move a step ahead and want to do something deeply in AI, you have to build bots or technology which is around NLP, right? And when you build something around NLP, you give a lot of power to the bot or the technology in the center to take decisions, like you said, that the technology in the center can take a call whether the publisher A should be capable of running a campaign C, and then what should be the payout. And then when the publisher also starts another conversation with the bot around what should be, maybe if he commits a huge number, which he or she can, you know, deliver, then the bot can maybe increase the costing and give him a priority on the validations, which right now affiliate managers do very, very manually, right? So I think the first part of the AI, which is very rule-based, is quite simple to manage. Once we go a deep down level, want to build something around NLP, I think that's where the industry will see a big, big revolution in sense. Affiliate goes on the AI channel. That's my personal opinion on that.
And is there anything happening on the second part on the NLP
side? Yeah, we are actually building a not to market ourselves, but just since the question is asked, we're building a strong tool around how we're going to in the future manage a major chunk of our affiliate channel through AI, and that's not going to just cover how the section works, but it's going to cover from the time the merchant comes on board and the campaign is set up, the time it goes to the publishers and they'd start delivering it, and even the data points which are going to be passed on to the affiliates in terms of a payout or the validations or whatever XYZ things we discuss, they're going to be part of that whole thing. But we have to be careful not giving it too much control that you know the AI starts harming the entire ecosystem. But yes, something we're building very strongly on.
So brands start using this in the near future. That's what you're saying, right? I mean, there would be a lot of experimentation. There would be a lot of learning. But
I would assume very soon. I mean, not like a long, long distance, but I think they should start doing it very, very soon.
I have to say something that two types of AI. One is what controls the affiliate marketing and what converts the campaigns. So we started as a value leaf since last year now. We are experimenting a lot on how we can generate a business to my clients through chatbots, which we are very successful in that. I think response is also huge. You know, we talk in digital marketing, CTRs and CRs, how is that? So kind of how to improve that angle. And luckily, most of the brands, they are willing to look at it, they are seeing it, and we are doing a lot of experiments on it. And we started working with 5 to 6 brands, and our ratios are at least 5 times higher than what we are doing through the conservative digital marketing. The digital marketing also became a conservative one day because of the chatbot and these things has come in.
Okay, so what we'll do is let's change the format a little bit, right? We all of the four panels, right? They've put together a small presentation where they want to share their insights on the future of affiliate marketing. What we'll do is we'll shift to that so that you guys also have some information about the future. So let's start on that, and then I'll ask each of the panelists to spend probably 3 to 4 minutes on the slides. And you have some nice takeaways from this session. Great, so let's start with that. So before we start, how many of you guys know who this gentleman is? Does anyone know? I hope somebody really knows. You guys can also look back if you guys haven't seen this person. I'm talking to the panelists. So he's William J. Tobin, and he's the person who patented affiliate marketing, right? He's the person in 1994. So he's a person who's run several businesses. He's run at least 10 businesses. He has 15 plus patents. He's done so many businesses altogether. He's been an inventor, a researcher, and so on. For his business, it was called PC Flowers and Shops. And for that, he launched affiliate marketing. He individually signed up more than 20,000 affiliates on his website. And that is when this concept came in. And you know, it's solely because of this person that all of us are sitting and discussing this topic. So yeah, I mean, that's a short trivia. And then what I want to do is I want to ask Neha to take over and just spend a few minutes on explaining the marketing trends in affiliate marketing. So Neha, please.
So start with the affiliate marketing trends to look out for in 2018. I have jotted on some 5 trends which I think to look out for 2018. So we first is influencer marketing. We've always seen that we've always taken influencer marketing and affiliate marketing in a different manner. But now we see a lot of influencers are coming and onboarding as publishers, and we are paying them on performance basis. And as a company, we have onboarded a lot of such influencers like YouTube bloggers, or WhatsApp groups, or Instagram followers, whereby people talking about the product, and we integrate a buy now button with them. We have integrated a lot of YouTube bloggers talking about products. We have done it for a lot of our brands. Second is setting up an affiliate channel or an affiliate program. Many clients have an issue with transparency, tracking platform. So it is very important for small to bigger clients to have an affiliate channel and affiliate program so that publishers know where to sign up, how to grow their account, and how to take it ahead. Here's an example of a publisher called Beer Biceps who does marketing us for a lot of campaigns. We give them products and they promote it.
Just a question on influencer marketing, because I think that is, at least for me, it's a little new to listen to influencer marketing and affiliates, right? What are the models on which it typically works? Is it so in affiliate, I would typically work on a CPS model or a CPA
cost
model.
Cost per sale.
Cost per sale is cost what you work sale. On affiliate influencer?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's interesting.
So like you see in the picture, there's a jockey campaign which is exclusive to us, and we have set up an affiliate program, and you see on the bottom there's a link of affiliate program. It is very important for clients to have that set up on the website. Next is cross-border marketing. If you see... For me, IN for India stands for international. And there has been 31% growth in the kind of people buying from cross-border. So what is cross-border marketing first? So cross-border marketing is a client is selling a product and wants to sell their product across countries, like AliExpress, Shein, coming to India. It's a Chinese brand. And you see a lot of Indians are buying those products. More than 54,000 crores of ad spends has happened for cross-border marketing. This is something for networks to go global as a platform, look for publishers to look for global campaigns and such, and have such cross-border marketing in place. And this is how affiliate marketing.
What do you see in this? So, for example, I find this very interesting, guys, cross-border marketing. But one of the challenge a lot of medium-sized brands they face is that, you know, how do they take care of logistics and warehousing? So is it is this trend more for digital goods or is it equal for physical goods also?
So it's equal for physical goods also. So if you see, be it AliExpress or Shein, they are doing it on cash on delivery also. So there was a challenge with cross-border marketing in which people have to pay through their credit cards and all. And that's why PayPal coming into India and launching the campaign also to actually grow in that manner, where people can pay for such cross-border sales. So.
Okay.
And it is expected to grow further by 75%, according to a lot of reports. We have a lot of cross-border traders, Emirates, AliExpress, Shein, Jet Airways, where we're working, and we're helping global publishers to push these campaigns. Next is, tracking is a very important part in affiliate marketing. And it is very important, it is shifting from desktop to mobile, and a lot of people are transacting on mobile. 80% or 50% of traffic of most of the clients is through mobile. So it is very important for networks to have a very cross-device tracking of fingerprint detectors and a smart link technology whereby a person coming from a web buying on an app has to be tracked and that has to be attributed to the publishers.
So I think this is interesting. Yeah? If you can just talk a little bit more about maybe a fingerprint detector or a fraud detector tool. I'm sure all of us would like to learn a little bit more on where these technologies are available, because maybe we have not used it ourselves, or maybe we have, but we don't recognize that we are still using it.
So a fingerprint detector is like I'm watching an ad on a desktop and I'm clicking on the ad, and then I'm buying on my mobile. And it has been detected through the email ID and the logins that I'm using. And this is called a fingerprint detector technology, whereby you can track the order sales, which we have right now. We also have a lot of fraud detector tools to check on cookie stuffing, brand safety tools, whereby a lot of publishers doing brand bidding and all. And
okay.
As you know, there are a lot of ad blockers. There's an update from iOS and Google whereby a lot of technologies are facing in West. They're not able to track orders. So it is very important for networks to have those technologies whereby they can surpass those ad blockers and can track orders and can attribute it to publishers. So I think more than 40% of people in India use ad blockers, which hampers publisher attribution and sales. Multi-touch attribution is a very hot topic we always talk about. So there are content bloggers, content sites coming into it, and there's always a challenge where we always said that last click attribution has to be changed because we need a lot of publishers to come in and to talk and to be part of publishers. And we sometimes talk about first-click attribution, last-click attribution. But I think future of affiliate marketing comes with a multi-touch attribution where a lot of publishers can take part in. We can attribute each and every publisher for their contribution in any campaign. I think artificial intelligence, the biggest thing is that will it replace affiliate manager? It's a big question. I don't think so. It is going to enhance their job and it will help them getting reports, analysis, the kind of reporting which can help them which campaign to pick, what payout to be picked, and it can also help publishers to automate their SEO. There are a lot of software AI with AI technology which are coming in. Yeah.
Thanks, Neha. I think it was very insightful, and you know, all of us would definitely have a lot of questions. You know, I myself have a lot of questions which I'll talk to you about separately, because you know, as a brand, I am always looking for better solutions, be it affiliates or any other channel. We'll have a few words offline. What I also want to do now is that, you know, I'll ask Sahil to talk a little bit about future of affiliate marketing, right? And what are his thoughts on how this industry is progressing and what's the future like?
Thank you very much.
So just to start on a positive note, we'll never replace affiliate managers. If we have affiliate managers, no one should think their job is under scrutiny, I think. As Neha rightly said, so genuinely enhance the work we do as affiliate managers. And also, I think both from the sides of a publisher and an advertiser, I think it's going to add a tremendous amount of value around how we function as of now. So just going from the supply side, I think on the supply side, if we see, there's going to be a huge change in the way we work. I'm going to specifically focus on AI, all the five subjects on AI.
Yeah, let's do that.
So from the supply side, I think all the publishers here, I think there is going to be a huge change in the way we transact with networks, or for that matter, directly advertisers. I think right now everything we do is fairly manual in the sense, right from the time a campaign is set up, from the time a campaign is announced, from the time we start promoting it, and till the end when the payments are rolled out. I think once AI starts taking over it, which I strongly believe will very soon, I think you'll see all of that getting a lot more streamlined and a lot more automated. You'll also see a lot of big data coming in. As we always say, big data is going to help marketing. Yes, it's going to help. I think there's going to be a lot of big data which is going to come in, and the affiliates as such will provide it with a lot of intelligent data as to what is converting better, what is not converting better, and what are the other challenges and the addresses we'll have in that. What will change from a demand side? I think a lot. Again, if you look at the advertisers right now, most of the work we do is fairly manual, right? Right from the time we set up a campaign to the time we ask for, I think, new offers, then we ask for validations, and then it goes down to commercials. I think everything is happening in a very, very manual way right now.
Sahil, sorry, I have a question on the supply side, right? I mean, today, one of the things that I find is that the amount of targeting that is available to me when it comes to affiliates is... I don't find that many options if I say compare it to a Google or a Facebook advertising platform, right? How is that going to change, if you can share some thoughts?
I think honestly, when we talk about targeting, there is a lot of targeting available on the affiliate channel. But the major issue there is that affiliate channel is always treated as, I want sales. You can't tell Google, I want sales, right? You have to...
Yeah, and they have a CPS model.
No, they have a CPS model, but how evolved that is something we all know, right? But when you look at the affiliate side, the first thing a brand says is, I want a sale. And that's where the entire targeting options we have, or the publishers have, even through smart SDKs, they go for a toss, because even if you target the best user, the value of that brand from a branding side is never considered, right? Sale nahi aaya is the answer we get, right? So I think there are a lot of targeting options, which a lot of publishers sitting here also have. The day the brands start, understanding the value of them, I think you'll see a lot of brands pushing on it.
I think the affiliates will need to explain that to the brands,
yes.
And then the gap will...
Yep. And again, AI does help. We have a solution called InstaTalk, which we built last year, and we already have at least a dozen of customers working on it, wherein we don't sell at all on sales or leads. It's purely a branding solution run through the smart targeting options the publishers have. So I think definitely there are a lot of targeting options, just to answer it. It's not being utilized the way it is. Because whenever we talk to a brand, the first thing they say is, how do you give me sales, right? So even if they are not a brand, they still want sales. That's a bigger challenge, right? I mean, if you have a Myntra or a Flipkart or an Amazon wanting sales, that does happen because we all buy from Myntra or an Amazon, right? But when you see an unknown entity, a new brand coming up, they straight away come to a sale model, it doesn't work that way. Is I think one of the biggest challenges we face as a network, I'm sure everyone faces, right? So, and also it's not sales. I mean, just to put another thing across, it's not sales. That's something the brands don't get. Sorry if there are brands here. It's an acquisition. I mean, I always kind of try to explain to the brands I directly work with that it's not a CPS campaign, it's a CPA campaign. We are not giving you sales, we are giving you customers, which you are acquiring. Then you have to build the LTV of a customer by using other channels, through your social, through your email, through your SMS, whatever you have. So once we give them a customer, then they grow the value of the customer, not us. So I think
what I'd like to understand from you is, are the targeting options similar to what is available in the Facebook platform? They are much more or they are much less?
I think, to be honest, Facebook has a lot more. I mean, I think we have to be very honest and humble about it. Facebook is Facebook, right? So they have a lot more, but the channels which we manage also have a lot more deeper things, right? Like from a smart perspective, using SDK properly, we can even tell that all the people sitting here, you know, whose phone battery is generally lower than 20%. And if we're able to get that much amount of data, I think that's immediately a customer for a power bank, right?
Of course. We've heard of the Uber example.
Yeah.
But
then again, to address the challenge, I mean, we can't commit that 100 power banks would be sold. That's where the affiliate channel starts becoming like at the bottom of the layer, right? But yeah, I mean, we have a lot more targeting options, like a battery or whatever channel.
You're right. I think that's where creativity comes in, and that's where I also want views from you, right? How do you use creativity in terms of content? Like, after your points are done, I would like you to contribute more over there.
Yeah. So I was on the demand side. I think we've already spoken about it. I think the AI side of things will really make the whole affiliate channel a lot more mature. And also on the data point, I think AI will help the advertiser and the network and the publishers to have a crazy amount of data to play with at their fingertips, which can really help them, you know, upscale the entire ROI for each one of us. And also, lastly, I think APIs will play a deep role. We'll have the deepest level of APIs being built within the AI tools, which will help again the brands and the publishers to have a lot of data running directly through the API, and you can come to a data conclusion as soon as you want on affiliate marketing, which is not there right now.
Awesome. So look forward to these, and I'm sure you are also rolling out a few solutions. We look forward to those from you, right?
Thank you.
Thank you. Yep. So next I'll move on to, your slide. Srikant, I want you to spend a few times and focus more on your side, which is the creativity side, the side which is not just acquisition, not just sales, but also branding, right? And how do you position the brand in the right way? And also talk about your future trends that you want to talk about.
Yeah. I have a point of view. I think many may disagree or many may agree with that. And I'm so happy that so many people are here. They're so interested in the topic. I think we are not a brand building or brand image marketing.
Correct. Awesome. So that's what really makes a difference. It's not just traffic. It is the conversion rate that really matters.
Yeah. And also, I want to explain every affiliate sitting here. You do banner ads, you do email, you do SMS. One thing everyone need to understand that you are entering into someone's private space. All the website is not owned by you, Times of India, but the person is reading and you're putting an ad, which may not really reader want to read it. You want to escape it, you want to... So kind of every affiliate need to understand how we can make creative and ads more acceptable of any genre of the channels. That can be display, that can be email, that can be SMS. People need to accept, oh, this is interesting. Some people give so much 160-character SMS that there are 200 characters. Who got time to read all those things? How come you can make it in 3 words? How you can make your email into 5 words, where people can do it? How you can completely embed your campaign creatives into the existing property of websites or whatever it is? That's how people, I think, that's how people respond. The CTRs are high.
You're right. And now with videos coming in, right, we all hate ads when we see videos, right, all of us. So that's where probably the true creativity would also come in.
We never hate any ad. Jab Zuzu aaya tha, bas everyone want to see that. Hey, don't change the channel. Let's sit, wait. I want to see what is the new concept. This is what we did. It's always how you are putting the creative, how you are showing the content is very, very important. You need to work on. No one hates any ad. No one hates any creative. The way you show, you must work on that creative and content show. Because people, I send an email campaign, and my competitor send an email campaign. Same data. He got, for example, 20% unsubscribe. And I got 1%. Just different. Same people, same campaign, same thing. But I showed the campaign, I showed the product. Buddy, you need this.
Are you guys doing anything with OTTs like Hotstar or Woot or...
So we work with a lot of, not Hotstar, we did a little campaign, but we do with so many brands of various products. And we try to showcase, buddy, you need a credit card, how it will help you. I'm not selling a credit card, but you need it.
So Srikant, let's quickly talk about these points, what we have displayed right now, and then what's your view on future of affiliate marketing?
I thought I'm done. It's still there.
You're done?
Okay. No, it's there. Let me go through. Yeah. Balancing the brand budgets, increasing. This is what, what happened. Most of the brands, they give the budget how to do TV, because I'm coming from marketing, because I can talk easily from both angles. I'm 3 years into this industry, and I was 10 years into the, I'll take one more minute.
Yeah,
one more minute, exactly. Okay, so what is happening now? It is people, the agencies and affiliates coming towards and make a budget for it. Ask for it what you want. Will you sit with me? Understand what I want. You don't give me anything. Understand my perspective first. Then do the corrections. Just don't ask for sale. Rightly, Sahil, you told right. Don't ask for the sale. Ask for acquisitions. Understand the journey, how we are going to get it. Talk to us and make it happen. I think most of the brands, I think I'll come next week to you, most of the brands are doing this. They're encouraging, yes, we will do it. We changed recently, one of the bank is in a trouble for credit card. I don't want to name them. But we created a completely new thing for them.
Okay, awesome. So let's, what we'll do is now move to Marino. One of the most interesting parts about this presentation should be that we take a look at the international affiliates. What's happening internationally? So we've seen views from India. We've seen views on the creative side, on the AI side, on the platform side. So let's talk a little bit about the international side, what's happening over there, and then we'll summarize this and take up a few questions if you have time.
Thank you. So being on the international side, but I consider India my second home, as I've been here for 10 years now. And in other seven places around the world, we operate in 40 different countries. So we have a privileged point of view when it comes to the affiliate networks and the attribution stuff. Because we have been both, as we are, retargeters. So we work on the performance side. We have been both on the supply side, because affiliate networks has been for a long time our top clients through which we got to the big brands. But now we are also affiliate network with Profiliad in India. So we know both sides, and the technology is helping us to try to find a right path. So in fact, the logical which we launched our machine learning technology is a supply path optimization. That helps us a lot, and the client, of course, to solve the issue after the head and beating that Google launched, where the SSP were pushing a lot of pressure on DSP. But this is technology. Then it comes the attribution, which is a negotiation. And it's always been tough for those who provide the action, performer, to get the right attribution. Because, you know, the last click wins, it's really a little bit too narrow, considering the time where that is now. Everything has been
awesome.
Changed. Like in the past, it was okay, because we had a 30-day last click attribution rule based on post click, sometimes on post view. It was, it's a 15 years old model. At that time, there were few merchants online.
What do you see as the future of this, Marino? I mean, attribution model. How does it shape up in the future? How will it solve the problems for both the brands and the affiliate networks and the publishers? For all
you know,
of them?
We are an active member of IAB, which I know as something similar in Europe, which is a U.S. and European strong association of people of our ecosystem. We're pushing, even lobbying the governments to introduce new law when it comes to attribution models. So it's
those are international laws?
Yeah, that will start from the U.S. and Europe, and I'm sure that it will come, exactly as Michael Lee told, if you manage cross-country campaigns, so if you deal, for instance, our first client is the Expedia group. If you deal in, and we work for 20 countries plus, you cannot, change attribution model to different countries. So they will definitely come. But so far, I think it's a matter of let brand understand that a fair attribution model is benefit for all the players in the ecosystem. because the last click is now getting old, I guess.
Yeah, so looks very interesting, right? So, I mean, if I have to the key takeaways from this session, right? Me as a brand, I feel very excited when I see that, you know, there are so many targeting options that are going to be available. When there's a lot more creativity in the affiliate side, when there is machine learning that's going to eliminate the fraud, when there is international laws that are going to standardize affiliate marketing, these technologies, the platforms and everything, I think that's what I really look forward to. And then, you know, I as a brand would want to work with affiliates, not just on a cost per sale model, but on branding campaigns, on any campaign which adds value to the brand. So thanks all of you. Thanks for being part of this discussion. And I really value your insights.
I think this has been a very, very engaging session, and I'm afraid we're not really left with a lot of time for Q&A. So if we can discuss the question and answers offline, that would be great.
Yeah, in fact, I also have a lot of questions, so I'll discuss with these guys, and you guys can also join in.
Because a couple of members did approach me for a question, like a couple of questions.
Yeah, we'll do that. Let's do that.
So
yeah.
If we can do that offline, it'll be great. Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a huge round of applause, please? Thank you. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Thank you, ma'am.